Today is the eighth day Sabbath that the Most High has orchestrated to follow the 14 days of his Feast of Ingathering. It is the 22nd day of September on his servant Satan's calendar. Once again, things are not unfolding in the same manner that I have spoken that they were going to. However, they are still unfolding according to how our Maker is causing them to unfold. Yesterday's completion of the third tier of the 270 days of him bringing forth the second man-child has brought forth the second of the dual man-childs that are his dual anointed sons. The many, many proofs of this that he gave to us in the testimony of his word that testify to this fact are undeniable if you believe into his word. And I do believe into his word. In light of this, I am quite confident that the time is at hand for the opening wide of his end time son of Adam's mouth. His first anointed son told us that the living waters are going to flow out from the belly of one that believes into Kikwe's word. And this has been happening for these past 7.5 years with Kikwe turning the waters of his statutes into his only begotten son's shed blood through his second anointed son. And yesterday's last great day of this 14-day feast that Yeshua marked when he spoke these words about these living waters has brought an end to this 7.5 year period of time. So far today, the Almighty has not let loose the great physical affliction that will follow this mark in time, at least not that I know of, since I, the time of this, that I'm recording this, I haven't been on the internet to check the news since this morning. His holding back doing so testifies to his long-suffering and to the fact that he is not going to take pleasure in doing this. Instead, he desires that the wicked would forsake your wickedness and turn back to him in order for him to heal you. What he has accomplished thus far in sending me to you in the precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little and there a little manner that he has, is that no amount of him fulfilling his prophecies that he gave to us in the testimony of his word is going to cause you to believe him and to obey his voice until he lets loose the destruction on a physical plane. I'm not sure when he is going to begin to plead with you on these different terms that will cause some of you to listen to him. Perhaps he will begin to humble you before his faces 3 days journey into the 7 days that began today that I've spoken about in recent videos. Here is one thing that is for sure in this. In addition to the many warning cries that he has sent me with, the many warnings that he has been sending on a physical plane are being seen throughout the soils that the inhabitants of the land dwell upon. Another thing that is for sure in this is this. None of these soils are soils that flow with milk and honey except for the soil that is beneath the place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here. This is the place to escape the toil. One of the many early warnings that he has sent ahead of him letting this loose is dual pairs of hurricanes. He spoke of these dual hurricanes at the end of Proverbs chapter 30 in verse 33. And Proverbs chapter 30 is most certainly an end time prophecy. He says, because the churning of milk brings forth butter, and the churning of wrath brings forth blood, and the churning of dual wrath brings forth my controversy. When you churn milk to bring forth butter, it has the same appearance that hurricanes do from space. He sent the dual hurricanes Harvey and Irma upon the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel as a very small display of his wrath. And then after them, he sent the dual hurricanes Jose and Maria heading this way. However, thus far, he has kept them from making landfall in this filthy cesspool of a land. He caused the Hebrew tongue to use the doubling of words and even the dual grammar notation with them to put a double emphasis upon them and to also point to his doubling of the 7 days of this seventh month feast that ended yesterday. He also gave us other illustrations of him doing this with the doubling, such as his using the dual sides of the dual sets of stone tablets that his finger wrote upon the dual sides of each tablet, and his doubling, the doubling of him telling us that he was going to send me to you in the precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line upon measuring line, here a little and there a little manner that he has in his Isaiah chapter 28 prophecy. His holding back Jose and Maria from being able to make landfall upon this soil as major hurricanes parallels his small, quiet voice that he has sent me to be up until this point, and it also parallels his continuing to hold this back. However, these dual churnings have still accompanied him bringing forth the man-child from the womb of Mother Israel. Jose is the Spanish word for Joseph, and Maria is the Spanish word for Mary. Joseph and Mary are still churning in the eastern ocean of the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. Yahweh tells us that his dwelling place is in the east, and his word also tells us that he has risen up his dwelling place in the west of your land at this time. Lightning has indeed been sent in the east, and it will be seen in the west in the coming days, now that he has risen me up. And when he lets you see this, he is going to do so suddenly. His word says so. Concerning his controversy that he has with you, he tells us the following in Hosea chapter 4, verse 1. Listen to Yahweh's word, because Yahweh has a controversy with the children of Israel and with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor favor, nor knowledge of Elohim in the land. The favor that he is talking about is the favor for favor that he has sent me with. However, you have refused to seek his favor on his terms. Therefore, he has refused to give you the favor of his only begotten son's shed blood. I'm going to keep this video short. He caused me to produce it to tell you that he has marked the birth of his second anointed son. He has done so with the testimony of his word. Yahweh's dual anointed sons have spoken that a wicked and adulterous generation seeks after a physical sign. In light of this, I can assure you that the physical sign that will be in the skies tomorrow of the woman that is clothed with the sun and has the moon under her feet and the crown of 12 stars is not going to be a good sign for those of you that are not dwelling upon this soil that flows with milk and honey. And since it precedes the third day of these seven, in light of the third day and the seventh day of his magnification of his waters of separation and his touching the naked and the dead life of Adam's statute, it might very well bring forth my father letting this loose. I do not know. I do know that he has exhibited his long suffering for a very, very, very long time, and that he has sent me with volumes of warnings such as this. I also know that the time for him to do so will one day come to an end, and that it is going to do so at some point in the days that are ahead, and this one certainly looks like a very real possibility. The churning of his dual wrath named Joseph and Mary off of your eastern coast, and him sending this hyped up physical sign of the woman bringing forth the man-child in his dual heavens tomorrow, certainly combined together to be a powerful warning. Yet this too is not enough of a warning for you. This is why his hot indignation will finally be let loose in the days that are ahead when he ceases from warning you. He sent his dual anointed sons to tell you what his truth is and what will cause him to give his favor upon you and with the knowledge of him, but you have refused to dance to the music that we have been sent with. The way that he has manifested these revelations to you has been incredible. All you needed to do was believe his word and let it be your only measuring rod, and then do what his word that he has put upon the one that his word testifies to has told you to do, and you could have had his favor bestowed upon you, favor for favor. But you have not wanted his terms. You have not wanted for him to delight in you. Therefore, you have not received his favor. The whirling wind of our fathers is indeed causing the winds to whirl like the churning of milk, and like most of you can see, the physical signs of where we are at in time are all around us. Here is something for you to consider. If these physical signs that are all around us are real, and they are signs of the times, then where is his end time Elijah that he was going to send to us before the great and the fearful day of Yahweh to restore all things? Where is his Michael that he was going to send to us from Greece, clothed in linen and girded with the golden belt, to tell us what is recorded in his scriptures of truth? I will tell you. His word testifies to the fact that he is the one that is speaking to you in this video. Regarding there being no truth in the land and no knowledge of Elohim at this time, per this Hosea prophecy, is it too difficult for you to understand that his word tells us that he was going to send this Michael to us at this time to tell us what is recorded in his scriptures of truth, and that none of you were going to cease with him when he sent me? No, this is a very, very, very straightforward. The reason that you cannot understand this is because you are a stiff-necked and obstinate people that are risen up in pride and in arrogance above the testimony of his word. Well, get ready to be shaken and prepare to smoke before his faces if you still refuse to come out from your whoredoms to him to be his separated people after he shakes your uncircumcised soil that your dual feet are upon.